Just wish that I only have one servant of God. That's the best introduction that you can give. But anyway, if there's a will, there's a maze. Tama ba yun? All right. But you know, I like your icebreaker. But I have another icebreaker for you. Jay, can you please? I have a mathematical problem. Pera ka dito, friend. Okay, so I'd like to show you a mathematical problem. So 5 years ago, John's age was half of the age he will be in 8 years. How old is he now? Get your paper and pen. Go for 30 seconds. Okay. 5 years ago, John's age was half of the age he will be in 8 years. How old is he now?
Years old.
Years old daw. Pera ka dito, Fran, ha? Okay. So while you're thinking, as if you are thinking, so let me ask you, how many of you here are in the discipline ng IT or engineering? There you go. IT and engineering. Okay. How many are in the education sector? Maliban kay Fran. Wala? So the rest of you, ano kayo? Okay. So the reason why I ask, you see, there are many ways we can solve a mathematical problem. Alright? You can do this arithmetic, by arithmetic or by algebra, or even trigonometry if you want, or geometric, or even numerical analysis. You know, kasi I'm an electronics communications engineer by profession, so yung highest math na pinag-aralan namin nun is the numerical analysis. So medyo nabaliw po ako noon ng mga panahon na yon. So mukha naman, di ba? Mukhang baliw ngayon, no? So yun, there are so many ways a problem can be solved, and there are many solutions that you can have for a particular mathematical problem. But I tell you one thing, no? Even though there are many solutions, there are many ways how to solve the problem, there is only one correct answer. Right? Did you get it na? Mamaya na natin, balikan yan, no? Okay, mamaya na. All right, so another thing is finding direction. Let's say, me, I'm going from here to CCF Eastwood. I'd like to go to CCF New Manila, where we are doing our church planting. Which route should I take? Diba? How many of you are using Waze? Diba? Some of us, or many of us. Ako, kayo, kung you are riding Uber or Grab, you can still use Waze, eh, diba? So you can ask the driver, or you can direct the driver how you want to go to your destination. So, if you're using Waze, for those who are using, will it be the fastest time to get there or the shortest distance, no, to cover? Ano yung pipiliin nyo? So, for example, no, ito ay sabi ko kanina. So, I'm here in Eastwood. I'm going to New Manila. There are 3 different routes, no, routes that I can take. And at the end of the day, I have to decide whether I will take the shortest time to cover or the shortest distance. But in this case, it's both the shortest distance and the shortest, the fastest time to get there. So, how many ways, that's pun intended, you can laugh if you want, do you have in order for you to get to your intended destination? So, there are many ways which you can follow in order for you to arrive at your final destination. But you know, tonight we will discuss that there is only one way, and there are no other ways, no, except in finding the way, the truth, and the life. There is just one way, and we know that that is Jesus. Shall we all pray? Father God in heaven, indeed, Lord, we are amazed at the things that we can do, the things that are that we can come up with in terms of finding solution to problems. But Lord, tonight, you would like for every one of us to understand and to believe that there is only one way and that there are no other ways, Lord God, to get to you and to be reconciled with you. Father, we pray that you will open our hearts, you will open our minds, and that, Lord, we ask that you fill us with the Holy Spirit, Father. And Lord, I pray that you empty me of myself and fill me, Lord God, with your Holy Spirit, Lord God. Speak to me and through me in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen and amen. All right. So, in this session, we shall together discover and affirm the answer to the questions. Is there a way to God? And if there was, is Jesus Christ the only way to God? So, actually, the need is, there is a borderline difference here about the felt need and the real need. The need to know where they will spend eternity. That's actually the question. Now, that is actually the issue. The need to know where they will spend eternity. People feel that they need to do something to get their way to heaven. No, with or without God. On the other hand, the real need naman is to acknowledge that we need God in order to get there, and there is only one way, no other way for us to reach God or to have eternal life. So the felt need, again, is there a lot of ways to God and to heaven that people believe or would like to believe? Diba? Likewise, that includes good works. No, people think that if they're doing good, if they're doing charity, if they are performing good works, they will get to heaven. Second, they think that they are good enough or righteous enough. I'm good naman eh. I'm a spiritual man. I go to church every Sunday. I go to fellowship. I mingle with other believers. So therefore, I am a good man. I am righteous. And then third, no? The third popular way by which people think that they can go to heaven is by a religion. No? People tend to seek answers through religion. No? That's the three. Those are the three reasons or the things that people think or do, no? Or conduct in order for them to have the answer to their question. Is Jesus is the only way to God? So yun ang question. But the real need is that we need to realize that Jesus is the only way. Diba? Diba yun yung kanta natin kanina? Jesus is the only way to God. And you know, there are a lot of people, when we preach about this, there will be some naysayers. They will ask, why are you the only ones who are right? Feeling nyo kayo lang ayos? Feeling nyo kayo lang yung magaling? Diba? Yun ang question nila. And some of them are even asking, why is your way the only right way? So, yun yun eh. There are so many people who think they know best, who believe that with this statement, no, they are so honest enough, honest expression of their beliefs, but you know, we can be and they can be honestly wrong. Tama? You can be, no, having the, you can have this belief, but you can also be honestly wrong. So those are the questions that are being posted, or those are the challenge given by the naysayers. But in Proverbs 14:12, I'd like for you, for us to read this aloud. Again, let's all read. There is a way that seems right to a man, but its end is the way to death. So the Bible is so clear, di ba? The Bible is so clear that there could be so many ways that people think that people, no, trying to find ways, but its end is the way to death. That is the Bible teaching. But you know, before we proceed further, so why is Jesus the only way to God and to eternal life? Because the Bible tells us so. Yun, no? And this is the premise of our discussion tonight. Belief in the Bible as the Word of God Himself, as well as belief that there is a God, and that God is a triune God, okay? And that Jesus is God incarnate. So Jesus is the only way. Proof, again, let us make reference to what the Bible is saying. So, in John 14:6, Jesus said, let's all read aloud, said to him, no one comes to the Father but through me. So Jesus was very clear on how to. Diba? I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. So let's dissect. What does it mean? No one comes to the Father. Number one, it's being reconciled with God. Secondly, it's salvation, or eternal life, or heaven, or paradise, or what we also call the blessed hope. So number one, reconciled with God. In 2 Corinthians 5:19, that is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. What reconciliation God is telling us? What reconciliation Paul is preaching to the church in Corinth? No, we know that men are sinful. We are all sinners, right? Sino dito ang hindi makasalanan? Raise your hands. Wala. We are all sinners. And therefore, because we are all sinners, we are all sinful nature, we have this sinful nature, no, we are separated from God. We were separated from God because God hates sin. He abhors sin. Totally rejects sin. No, because He is a holy God. And therefore, when Christ came, one of His mission is to reconcile the people, the sinful people, the sinners like you and me, to God the Father. So that is the first thing. When He said that no one comes to the Father except through Him, that means Christ is reconciling you and me to God the Father. Alright? So, next verse. And through Him, to reconcile to Himself all things. And when we say all, is there any exception? Thank you for your response. Oh, you're very, cooperative. Na? All things, meaning lahat. All. No exception. Whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of His cross. It all starts and ends on the cross. Jesus is the way, the only way, because Christ is reconciling us to God the Father by the blood of Christ's cross. So that is the first item that I'd like to point out. Reconciled with God. Then, salvation. For by grace you have been saved. So, through faith. Sorry. And this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. Because we are all sinners, we are sinful. Therefore, we cannot save ourselves. And that is why, by grace alone, no, by the grace of God, through faith, you have been saved through faith, not on your own doing. No, because we, as a human being, we, even though how good you are, how good you think you are, you really cannot achieve salvation by your own accord. Because God is the only way. Jesus is the only way. No? For by grace you have been saved. Para wala daw tayong ipagyabang. So that no one may boast. Because some of us, because we think and feel and believe that we are good enough, because we are famous, because we are so fortunate, because we have lots of fortune in this world, we think we can buy our way to heaven. But no, by grace only, you are saved through faith. And that faith is to Jesus Christ alone. Okay, and then next, eternal life. Oh, we are very familiar with this. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him. Now that is very clear in the passage. No, not your religion, not anything else, not anyone else, no other prophets, no, old and new, can save you. But whoever believes in Jesus Christ should not perish but have eternal life. So that's the promise. If you have Jesus Christ, if you believe in Jesus Christ, you will definitely have eternal life. Next, diba? What's heaven? Diba? In John 14, 1-3, that is the pretext before he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Let not your hearts be troubled. Are you troubled after Valentine's Day? No? Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me, Jesus Christ. In my Father's house are many rooms. Now, in the old translation in KJV, in my Father's house, there are many mansions. So that's heaven. So as believers, you are assigned your condo unit in heaven. You have your own mansion. You have your own room. Now, if it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will take you to myself, that where am I, you may all be also. So is there any other prophet? Is there any other teacher? Is there any other who's claiming to be God who made this promise? There's none. Only Jesus Christ. That he said, no, that where I am, you may be also. No, because there are many rooms. Kasya pa. So if there is any one of you here who hasn't accepted the only way, the only truth, and the life, meron pa, kasya pa. Wala pang last trip. Okay? Then next, paradise. So, here he said, and he said to him, that was the one of the criminals, no? Crucified together with Christ. No, truly, nung sabi kasi, alam niyo naman yung story, di ba? By the way, walang pangalan po sa Bible yun, ha? Hindi po yun si Demas at Hestas. You will nowhere find in the Bible those names. So, hindi ko alam kung sino nagbinyag ng pangalan na yun. No? But then, yung two criminals na yun, one said, oh, if you are the King of Jews, why can't you save ourselves? Save us as well. But sabi ni isa, tumigil ka nga dyan. Tayo nga na makasalanan, we are sinners and we are suffering. No, we are deserving of this dying on the cross. But he is the Son of God. No, Father, sabi niya, Lord, please remember me when you are in paradise. And this is how Jesus responded to him. Truly, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. That's another promise. To someone who believe him, to someone who declare his deity, his being God. And the next, this is what we are all hoping for, the rapture or the second coming. It's totally different thing, but let's not dwell so much on that, you know, but later on, if we have time, pag-aaral natin yon. But waiting for our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. So who amongst the religious teacher can say that they are resurrected and they will appear again next time to meet you and, no, take you or have a date with you in the middle of the clouds? None. Only Jesus Christ. That is why he is the only way to heaven. And Paul, when they are being questioned by the Sanhedrin, in the book of Acts, in chapter 4, this is what, not Paul, sorry, Peter, this is what Peter told them. Let it be known to all of you and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him this man is standing before you well. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. So kabisaduhin niyo lang yung verse 12. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Again, is there any other religion or religious teacher or who they call themselves prophet who can claim this? None. Because there is no other name. Only Jesus. That's why Jesus is the only way. Are we clear so far? Okay, let's continue. So, Jesus is the only way. Likewise, I'd like for us to remember all these things. Jesus, justice is served through him. He extends mercy towards us. He saves us by substituting for us. He also provided an unending love and rich grace to us, for us. And then fifth one, seated at the right hand of God. Justice is served through him. You know, let's say you are sentenced to die. How is justice going to be served? Diba? If you're sentenced to die, justice is served by you being put to death. Right? You know, the dilemma of most of the people is that they think, no, God is good. God is love. So he will not allow me to die. He will not allow me to go to hell. Because he loves me. God is love, diba? By definition, God is love, true. But at the same time, people forget that God is also a just God. He hates sin. So how did God solve, quote unquote, his problem? I am holy. I should render justice, or I should give justice. But at the same time, I am love. So how? Sabi nga, but God demonstrate his own love for us in this. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. That's in Romans chapter 5, verse 8. You can check your Bible later. Baka sabihin nyo, binobola ko kayo. So Romans chapter 5, verse 8. Justice is served to him, no, by canceling the record of debt that stood against us, and with its legal demands, this he set aside, nailing it to the cross. Diba? We should be happy. We should be joyful. We should be rejoicing that God, through Jesus Christ, canceled the record of all our wrongs because he nailed it to the cross. Justice is served. He set that aside. Next, for God has not destined us for wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Friends, you know, God created all of us. He is love. He loves you and me, and therefore, he does not want us to go to hell. But his desire, his will, is for us to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Justice is served through him. And then he also extends mercy towards us. He saves us not because of works done by us in righteousness, but according to his own mercy by the washing of regeneration and renewal of the Holy Spirit. That's in Titus 3:5. No, not because of works done by us in righteousness, but according to his own mercy. Diba? What is mercy? Can you define mercy to me? Yes, Bran. Now you can join. Kanina, hindi ka pwede sa mathematics. What is mercy?
It's a punishment that you deserve but will not be given.
Okay. What is grace? Is it a reward? Yep. Mercy is something that you deserve, but you were not, no? No? You were, ang tawag dito, exempted. Tama? And grace is something that you never deserve, but still given. And the mercy of God is given through Jesus Christ. We deserve to die, no? But God gave mercy through Jesus Christ. We don't deserve eternal life. We don't deserve salvation, but God extends His grace. You see how the cross is so powerful that we, no, while we deserve punishment, God didn't. While we don't deserve eternal life, God gave us eternal life. And He did that by substituting for us. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. So lahat ng kasalanan ng sanlibutan, sa Kanya lahat bumagsak. And you know, that is the reason people are questioning the deity of God, of Jesus Christ, when He prayed on the cross, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? That is His cry. Because He felt, no, the weight of the entire sin of the world. And when God saw Jesus Christ during that time, He turned away, look away from Jesus Christ, because He cannot bear, no, the thought and the idea that His Son, that His beloved Son, is bearing the weight of the cross, bearing the weight of all your sins, of all our sins, past, present, and future sins, so that we will all be saved. And the Lord has laid on Him the iniquity of us all. You know, even non-Christians recognize what Jesus did. Sabi ni, sino siya? Hindi siya kalala. Kaibigan ko yan. Si Mahatma Gandhi. No? No? Sabi ni Mahatma Gandhi, Jesus, a man who was completely innocent, offered himself as a sacrifice for the good of others, including his enemies, and became the ransom of the world. It was a perfect act. It was indeed perfect. Jesus was the perfect, unblemished Lamb of God who died on the cross, who substituted for you and me on the cross. Imagine nyo kung kayo ipapako sa cross. Gusto nyo ba yun? Would you like to be hung on the cross and be nailed because of your sins? And after all, you are not perfect and you cannot pay for everything that you have done. But Christ did that for us. He Himself bore our sins in His body on the tree, that we might die to sin and live to righteousness. That is the reward, that we may live in His righteousness, to His righteousness. By His wounds you have been healed. For you were straying like sheep, but have now returned to the shepherd and overseer of your souls. So friends, He bore your sins. And therefore, by His wounds, you are all healed. So that you will live, no, in righteousness. And then, unending love and amazing grace. Sana yan, kaso baka kantahin natin. Unending love and rich grace provided for us. In Him, we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of His grace, which He lavished upon us in all wisdom and insight. Wow, ganun katindi. The richness of His grace He lavish upon us because He loves you and me. He could have come down from the cross. Isipin niyo yun, God, the Almighty God, the Son of God, Jesus Christ Himself, when He was ridiculed on the cross, He could have come down. No, He could have sent His multitude of angels to wipe out everyone. But He did, because of His grace. according to the riches of His grace. He wants to redeem us through His blood. Are you redeemed by His blood? And Ephesians chapter 2, verse 4 and 5, but God being rich in mercy because of the great love with which He loved us, even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. Love is the meaning of the cross. Christ, God, loves you so much. That's why He died for you and for me. And right now, He is seated at the right hand of God. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where God, Christ is, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. So here, if you have been raised with Christ, if you have Jesus Christ in your heart, if you have received Him as your Lord and Savior, you should live, seek the things that are above. Eternal ang perspective po natin. We should always be living this life from now on. If you receive Jesus Christ, moment by moment, your desire, your will is to always seek His will, and that everything is eternity. You are just thinking of eternal consequences. You are thinking of eternal things. Everything is eternal because that is where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. You know, gusto ko lang inject to. Before, when I was younger, wag niyong tanong kung ilang taon na yun nakaraan. When I was younger, when I shared the gospel, people will always question this, seated at the right hand of God. So, ibig sabihin, dalawang trono ng Panginoon. Oh, paisip ako ganun. Oh, nga, no? Eh, sino naman yung kaliwang kamay if He is seated on the right hand of God? Sino yung nasa kaliwa? Ba, hindi ko alam, sabi ko. But hindi ko alam, di pa ako nakarating dun eh. No, but you know, one of my mentor during that time, sabi niya, ang chair ba, isang ganyan lang? Can it be a long chair that can occupy two? God is sitting there and Christ is at the right hand. The throne, we don't know, but it can be possible. Right? Because Christ is seated at the right hand of God. And He worked, that He worked in Christ, that when He raised Him from the dead and seated Him at His right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name, that is name, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. So Christ is seated at the right hand of God, interceding for you and me. If you are a believer, if you are for Him, if you are with Him, if you are in Him, He is praying for you. He is interceding for you, God, so that you will live a life that is worthy of your calling and your choosing. But if you are not yet in Christ, if you haven't received Him as your Lord and Savior, then He is knocking at the door of your hearts and asking that you allow Him to come to you, so that He will also dine with you and eat with you and offer you the eternal life. So once again, friends, Jesus is the only way. You know, justice is served, extends mercy toward us, saves us by substituting for us unending love and rich grace, seated at the right hand of God. Ang galing, no? Jesus pala. Jesus is the only way. So now what? So now what? I'd like to end this message by leaving you this passage. Because if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart, one believes and is justified, and with the mouth, one confesses and he's saved. People, this is heart issue. Probably many of us are still struggling about our intelligence, about our knowledge, that we think And we believe of so many ways where we can reach God, where we can have eternal life. We think that we're good, we think we're intelligent, but what is said in the Bible? If you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. No? The distance between the head and the heart is just 1 foot away. The distance between hell and heaven is just 1 foot away. So friends, for with the heart one believes and is justified, and with the mouth one confesses and is saved. Let's all bow down our heads and pray. I'd like to pray for two groups of people. I pray for the first group who hasn't accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. You know, this is the day that the Lord has made. If that is you, if you think, if you feel, and if you believe that you haven't received the Christ who died on the cross, who gave his life for the penalty of your sins, past, present, and future, today, Jesus is knocking at the door of your heart. Will you please open your heart and allow him to enter your life and be the Savior and Master of your life from now on? If that is you, I'd like for you to pray with me this way. Father, thank you for allowing me to realize that your Son, Jesus Christ, is the only way to you by which I can be reconciled with you. Father, forgive me for all my sins. I repent from all that I have done wrong. Please forgive me and cleanse me from all my unrighteousness. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. And now I accept your Son, Jesus Christ. I accept you, Jesus Christ, in my heart, in my life, as my Savior and my Lord. Please come to me, Lord. And thank you. Thank you for the gift of salvation. I pray that from now on, I will live this life according to what you desire of me. Thank you once again for your mercy and for your grace. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. And for those of you who have long been a Christian and who have accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, but have forgotten the totality of what Jesus did on the cross, I pray that you will continue to allow him to work in your lives. Father, I pray that these people, Lord God, you will bless them in a way that they will live their lives according to your grace, according to your love for us, that we will continue to walk in this manner that you ought us to do, to be. Father, I pray for everyone in this room. I pray, Lord God, for blessing, the spiritual blessing that everyone ought us to have. Father, will you enrich us? Will you, Lord, continue to work in our lives? Thank you, Father God. And this we pray in Jesus' mighty and precious name. And all God people say, amen and amen. All right. By the way, would you like to know the answer to the mathematical problem? Okay ba? Pa, huwag ka na sumagot, ha? 5 years ago, John's age was half of the age he will be in 8 years. How old is he now? So it's step, di ba? As an engineer, step one ang ginagawa mo dyan. Let X, di ba? Yung mga engineer, mahilig sa X eh. No, you find X. Oh, hugot, oh. No, di ba? Find X, di ba? No, let X be John's age now, di ba? So, look at the question and put the relevant expressions above it. So, 5 years ago, X minus 5. Di ba? John's age was half. So, one half. The age he will be in 8 years. So, yan yung inyong equation. Susunod nyo, di ba? So, X minus 5 equals 1 and a half, parenthesis X plus 8. Bumundo ko na ba ilong nyo, no, iba? Okay, so yan yun. So, X minus 5, bonus lang yun. X is 18. Alright? Thank you, everyone. I hope you understand that Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. Okay? So, shall I pose the question now? Pran and ano? Shall I pose the question or not yet? Okay. So, I have two application questions that you need to discuss in your breakout group. Knowing Jesus said that He is the only way to God, how will you respond to this claim? Knowing that He is the only way, how would you now live your life as a believer? Thank you, everyone. Good night.
Yay. Thank you, Paul, Queer, then.